Hey guys, this is Amber, and welcome to day 10 of October Daily for 2021. So I kind of have a fun little page planned. Not going to be very hard, but I'm planning to do some interesting things with it. So I was inspired by this card here in Allie Edwards' Stories by the Month kit for... It's the physical kit for 2021, but the digital kit from 2020. This is obviously a 3x4, but I'm going to blow this up to be a full-size page. I don't know if you can see in the colors here, but it's orange, yellow, and black lines here. So in the digital, I'm going to change the yellow to a pink color. I'm hoping it will print out. I don't know if it's really going to turn out well enough, but I found this cool faded, like hot pink to clear vellum sheet at Hobby Lobby the other day. And I was thinking about layering it over this American Crafts paper. This is from Obed Marshall. I just thought it would have a really cool ombre effect. And, you know, I'm trying to do pink in the album a little bit here and there. So since it's 10 things in the 10th month, I dug through my December daily stash and I found this paper that I have. I want to say this is from 2017 or 2018. I'm not exactly sure, but it's the last 10 count day that I have. And what I'm going to do, it's obviously not going to be the full 8.5 by 11. I pulled this sheet out just to show how big it's really going to be. It's going to be the 7.5 by 9. And then my card is a strict 6 by 8. But what's awesome about that is it gives me room around the sides here and a space for my holes. And then I'm going to print this so that, and cut it. So I think it's going to be about 6¾ inches, maybe 6.5 inches. 7 inches. I have to double check my measurements, but it's going to lay something like this with this design printed on it. So it'll have a massive 10, two sets of 10, and I'm going to mount it in some way up here, maybe fold it over a little bit so that this can be lifted up and then you could read the journaling underneath. Now, when I do the journaling, what I want to attempt to do is find some fun little tiny word phrases in my stamps here. Let me dig out my stamps. My organized piles are becoming all mixed up here. Found these cool die cuts at Michael's. But let me dig my stamps out. Also be able to dig through other stamps because they don't necessarily have to be Halloween or fall themed to make sense on here. But I might do, try to find a good example. Maybe like I would stamp a little I heart candy and then put some notes. Or I might, you know, stamp Hocus Pocus and write about that being my favorite movie. Yeah, these aren't great examples of stamps that have those kinds of notes, but just ones that have like little sayings on them. So I could stamp like a tiny little saying and then write a little bit of journaling about 10 fun things in the 10th month. So I'm hoping it'll come out. My biggest concern is that the colors won't really print on here like I want because it's orange and pink on pink, but I'm not really sure what other colors to print them in besides just all plain black, and I was hoping that it will come out a little bit. So I'm excited to see how this is going to turn out. What I do need to do is measure where on my, because I'm going to put the whole sheet through the printer, where on my 8.5 by 11 I want this to print and leave myself room so I can basically do that and fold it over and where that will lay here so that I get the most pink. So I will be taking some measurements, making sure it's aligned like I want, and then print it, and then we will get started together. Okay guys, so just to give an idea of how I have this laid out, I have my paper centered where I want it. I want it to do a hot pink to kind of clear so that you can kind of see where the gradients are. And so that means, sorry, I gotta line myself up here, that at 1.5 inches is where I want my beginning of my print to start. Because remember, it's going to still be 9 inches tall and 7 inches wide. So what I did because I went to my Photoshop and I created a guide at 1.5 inches, so I knew where to align that. So I'm going to save that, print it, and then I'll know, like, that line won't print there, but I'll know where to cut and fold, and then I'll be able to trim the sides, which are 8.5 inches wide, down to 7, just to get things centered as I go through it. So I will show you what that looks like in just a moment. Okay guys, so you can see there where I have finished all my stamping and my journaling. I used a combination of Kelly Purkey, or actually, yeah, all Kelly Purkey inks and some VersaFine. So now I'm trimming my background paper to 7.5 by 9, which is the same size as all the other papers I've been using for full spreads here. And I'm trimming my vellum. So far I'm only trimming the height to 9 inches. Because I want to see where it's going to lay left to right on my project before I trim it out with the background paper. And I'm really loving how it's coming out. But like I said, just doing a little bit of fudging around, seeing, you know, where it's going to lay. There was a perfect spot where you could see those words in the middle of my writing, but I just couldn't make it work with the way I had already cropped the vellum, which was a bummer. So I'm getting my holes punched. Just using my punch template there makes it so much easier to punch things and line them up. You don't ever have to do any thinking. I highly recommend everyone makes one. And then here I'm going to use my Gina K traffic tape. I'm using the 1/8 size just to put a bunch of pieces in the corners. I could have used rolling adhesive, but since it's on the outside of a page protector, I just want it to be really secure. So just pulling back all the release tape. And I'm going to center it to the right-hand side there. And then here again, I'm just kind of looking at where I want it to be, and then I'm just grabbing a pencil and marking where I want to make my trims at, along the outside of the paper, the full 7.5 by 9 paper, that is. So I'm just making the trim, cutting off a little bit of pencil that's going to be showing through, and erasing any marks you might be seeing. And then I'm just trying to be like super careful, like measure twice, cut once kind of situation, because I don't want to accidentally cut it too short. So here I'm cutting it to where it needs to be, and then I remembered, oh yeah, it has to be shorter than the holes. So I'm going to end up cutting off about another 1/2 inch or so. To give it some clearance, that way when it's in the rings, you have room to lift the vellum up. So really loving how this is coming out.
I've seriously been enjoying doing this project, coming up with some fun ideas, being inspired by others. I'm loving pink right now. And then here I'm going to make some measurements with my ruler. I'm going to put 5 little mini star brads along the top to secure it in place. I had decided early on not to fold the vellum over. I just had a feeling it wouldn't lay right. And these would, you know, just give it a little something extra. So I end up putting them starting in at 1/2 inch, and then I think it's like another 1.5 inches each because of it's being 7.5 inches wide, something like that. Actually, it's only 7 inches wide, but I used my box to pierce the first holes just very, very lightly, and then in my hand, I'm just doing it again all the way through the paper.
And super happy with how this came out overall. The only thing I was a little bummed about is if I had thought about this, I would have maybe erased this, or like, because it's so close to being like visible in a different spot, but the way this is cropped, I can't move it, or I didn't realize where it was going to lay over my writing. But I love the ombre effect. I love that you can see everything, and the tens are there but subtle. You can still see that they're pink and orange, and the black kind of printed more of like a brown color, but it could have been that in the file and I didn't realize. But yeah, just use a couple little mini star brads. These are Recollections ones. It's like a mixed metals. I thought about a shiny silver, but I thought the more metallic would go better with the black, like the darker, dirtier looking color. And I didn't have enough black, and it seemed kind of stark, so I thought that was a good fit in between. And then when I do the next page, these will all be covered. But yeah, I think this came out so well. And if you'd like, I can share a little bit of my journaling with you. So I have the best season, and I'm just talking about why fall's my favorite season. I'm not going to read you the whole thing. I have decorating time that I love to decorate for fall. I love that it can be up for 3 months. Holiday movies, I'm talking about Hocus Pocus, it's my favorite, but I also Practical Magic, Casper from when I was a kid, and the Harry Potter movies as well. In the kitchen, I'm talking about fall baking season, being cozy, with cozy pajamas, curled up with books or movies and a blanket, a cat in my lap. So Much Beauty, I'm talking about changing leaves, how I'd love to decorate with pumpkins outside and inside, loving buying candy for trick-or-treaters and eating the leftovers, loving that my flowers are still blooming, and I have Remember This, and I'm talking about how much I'm enjoying doing this October daily project. So hope you enjoyed watching this. I love how it came out. It's even better than I thought in my vision. And I will see you for day 11. And just a reminder that if you subscribe to my channel, you'll be automatically notified when I post new content. And can't wait to share more. Thanks so much.
So just leaving you here with some final close-ups and letting you know I'll be away for a few days, going to Salem, Massachusetts with my family, so you won't get any postings for a few days. Thanks so much for the support.